If you want to become a better iOS developer, if you want to cut your development time in half, and if you like to get huge discounts, then this summer sale is for you. Save 30% on every and any product on my site with coupon code SUMMERSALE. Or save even more, 50% when you purchase all of my products. Yes, that's 50% off discount. Today, I'm going to go through all of my products, show you what they can do so you can benefit from them. All discount links are in the description, and let's get into it. This is the very first sale I make on store.rebeloper.com. So go ahead and check it out. It's at store.rebeloper.com/summersale. And this will be available only for 1 week. So please pay attention so you don't miss out. It's a 50% off sale. You get all of my products at half the price. Also, there's another sale going on the site according to the summer sale. And that is 30% off if you are purchasing individual items, for example, active text, currency field, and today we are going to go through all of them so you know what they do, so you know how to make a better judgment of what you actually want. Again, at the summer sale, it's 50% off. If you are buying on an individual level, then it will be 30% off of all of my products. So let's just take a look at our products. First off is active text. Let's open up this inside another browser. And this is actually the missing SWIFTUI text for handling hashtags, mentions, and links. So you can construct really easily this kind of tappable words inside a text. As you already know, SWIFTUI has an on-tap gesture, but that is on the whole text view itself. This makes it really, really easy because you have separate words that you can address. So, for example, at mention, hashtags, links, you can also replace certain words with any kind of view. Go ahead and check it out. It's active text. And of course, this is really easy to set up. As you can see, two steps, documented. I have a properly working Xcode project and it's compatible with, you know, the latest version of iOS. Now let's take a look at the next one because we have 12 of them and that is currency field. Let's open this up in another tab. This is the missing SWIFTUI text field for handling currencies. Now I've been struggling with this quite a lot and basically what this does is adds a currency field into your SWIFTUI apps without the hassle. As you can see now, it asks us with the dollar sign and the Bitcoin and SwiftCoin, USD, all of that automatically. Now, the cool part here is that it's going to add in these 2%, like whenever you add your cents, so it's not going to overlap. It also adds in this keyboard by default, the number keyboard, and also you can customize it. Either it will have a dot or a comma or none, for example, for the yens. Go ahead and check it out also. It's at currency field. Now, next up on the list is stickers, RMESSAGE. Let's just take a look at that. This is basically the easiest way to make money on the App Store. You just create a sticker pack and you create it in a way that you can have in-app purchases with it. Now, this is not straightforward. So yeah, basically that's why you need RMESSAGES for this. You can add in your stickers, configure them, have them as free or paid versions. And yeah, basically this is how it looks like. People can store them. You can have these multiple columns. It's really, really versatile. You can also have GIFs or APNGs, so animated PNGs that Apple supports. And as you can see here, we unlock them, store them. You have all of the in-app purchase functionality when you have to restore the purchases. So all of this is for in-app purchases inside an iMessage app. And of course, it looks really great on dark mode also. Next up is LOREM. LOREM is a really small tool that you can use for your development, and that's LOREM Ipsum and LOREM Pixum for your development. LOREM Ipsum is, you know, it just adds LOREM Ipsum text to your text, and LOREM Pixum does have images that you can add in from people, nature, all of that stuff. Setting up is really, really easy because all you have to do is just drag and drop, and then you can just use Lorem Ipsum, person 6. Also, you can have a random image, a random person, or just go for back to school. It's 100% documented again. Next up is Flow View. Now, Flow View is actually really nice because now we can have flow layout in SWIFTUI. So basically, this is how it looks like. It's just having views one after the other, and if the last one on the list doesn't fit it into the whole width of your container, then it will be put back onto another line. And of course, this has an alignment of leading, trailing, or center if you wanted to. I do have an example Xcode right over here, but basically all you have to do is just two steps, and just add the library into that and just use flow view with your data, vertical spacing, horizontal spacing, alignment, and then you get back that data. In our case, it's a profile, and you just use that into the profile cell. And of course, we have this vertical and horizontal spacing features and alignment. Whew, a lot to uncover here. As I said, it's 12 of these products. It's at store.rebeloper.com/summer-sale. It's 1 week. You get 50% off. Now, if you do want to purchase them individually, it's 30% off with the code, coupon code. When you check out, go ahead and add in summer sale. Okay, StoreKit Pro. Now, StoreKit Pro is one of my favorites and one of the followers' favorites. It's in-app purchases made easy. So, yeah. If you are having in-app purchases in your app, you want to have StoreKit Pro because it's really easy to set up. As you can see, step 2, configure your in-app purchases. Maybe configure the StoreKit Pro like you just started up, and then just purchase product.buy. And of course, there's a lot more: fetching products, restoring purchases, purchase a product, purchase consumables. You know, consumables are really, really hard to handle because, yeah, they are not about the receipt from Apple. Also, with StoreKit Pro, you don't need a receipt from Apple. All of that is handled by StoreKit 2 from Apple. Buying coins, get a consumable account, and there's quite a lot that you can do. It also works on all the platform, macOS screenshots, as you can see right here, iOS screenshots. So this is one of the favorites, StoreKit Pro, navigation stack. Now, as you already know, I am a navigation junkie in SWIFTUI. So what I have done is made sure that navigation in SWIFTUI is as easy as possible. And yeah, now you can have easy navigation in SWIFTUI. You have pop to root, you have pop to a certain index. You can navigate to any view that you'd like. All you have to do is just set up. It's kind of a coordinate pattern for navigation. You just set your views up and then you just navigate. Let me just show you how easy it is. You just present the home second. Home container navigation, flow, present, home second, and that's it. And also you can present with the same syntax, a sheet, a full screen cover. You can check on dismiss, you can pop. It's really, really versatile. One of my favorite products ever. Okay, pick any media from Media Picker. Let's check that also out. You know, picking images and videos, live photos, PDFs. It's really hard to do so. Now it's iOS 16. SWIFTUI made it a little bit easier. You can pick images, but not videos, live photos, PDFs. But with Media Picker, you can do so. And it's a 4 easy step setup. You just have a state object of Media Picker service. You create a Media Picker sheet. And then finally, you just present live photo, selection limit, and all of with all of those properties. And then you can just use the result that you get back from there to maybe just populate or save to another server or whatever. And yes, you can pick anything, even audio, MP4, PNG, icons, SVG, etc. So here's the whole list of what you can pick. You can pick audio, MP4, icons, SVG with the document type. So yeah, it is really, really versatile. Next up on the list is keychain vault. Now, if you like to have your data secured, like inside a keychain, that's kind of cumbersome to use keychain in iOS. But now with keychain vault, it's really, really easy to do so. So declare your variables, set your values, and then you just get your values. And that's it. Also, you can set, get, delete manually if you choose to control who can access your data. You can have iCloud keychain accessibility incorporated or use access groups for multiple apps to use that keychain. All of this is 100% documented again, and I do have a video and a an example Xcode project. So it's really, really nice. Now, if you don't really like navigation, like you just need a simple navigation, no deep links that Swift navigation stack offers, then you just go with SWIFTUI navigation. It's the easiest navigation that you can have in SWIFTUI. Just go navigation.present, a page, a sheet, and you just check on dismiss, or a full screen color, and that's it. And setup is only two lines of code. You just grab a navigation, and then just uses navigation. And after that, you just use those free present functions. You either present a page, a full screen cover, or a sheet. And that's it. Simple navigation in SWIFTUI. Now, we have SWIFTUI Toast. What is actually SWIFTUI Toast? Well, there isn't something like this in SWIFTUI. It's actually a progress hub. And this is how it looks like. You see, you have a title, you have the description, you have kind of this progress view that is spinning. You can have this on different alignments, top, center, bottom. You can have on different appearances, as you can see, on light and dark mode. So it's the lightweight Toast for SWIFTUI. It's really easy to use, and when you do have something to show for the user that, okay, this will take quite a lot of time, maybe you are fetching something from the servers, you do need to inform your user, and just do it in a SWIFTUI Toast. Okay, and finally, we have Swift Encryption with Crypto Manager. Now, what is Crypto Manager? If keychain is not really enough for your safety, then you want to encrypt your data. Now, encryption is really, really hard in iOS. Of course, we have CryptoKit from Apple. And by the way, Crypto Manager is using CryptoKit under the hood. But, you know, you can encrypt and decrypt with only one line of code with Crypto Manager. And for example, here we have our password, Crypto Manager password. Encrypted password data, you just go password.encrypted, and then decrypted password, you just grab that encrypted password and you just grab the decrypted string. And it uses CryptoKit and uses also wallet for that is Square's repository for keychain management and all of that. It's 100% documented, and I do have an example project for it. And of course, if you need to, it's also syncing to iCloud keychain, which is really, really nice. Also, there's video documentation. It's really, really great. So those were the 12 products that you can have today for 30% off on my site, store.rebeloper.com. It will be lasting only for 1 week. So last day is August 29th. So yeah, it is a summer sale. Also, if you, and yeah, that 30% off is with coupon code summer sale, or just follow the link in the description. Also, there is a bundle where you can have all of my products for 50% off. That's half the price. It's at store.rebeloper.com/summer-sale. Go ahead and check it out. I highly recommend it if you need this. And if you do want to incorporate in-app purchases into your apps, make sure to check out this video right over here.